Hello, Assalamu alaikum. My name is Mohammed Talha. Good evening, everyone. Today we are going to talk about air pollution. The air quality is extremely important to us, yet pollution is getting worse day by day. Today we are going to talk about the air pollution. We have an honorable guest, Mrs. Ichai, with us.
Hi, Ahmed and Talha, and a very good evening to everyone.
There is not everyone in today's world who can answer the question, what is air pollution? Ms. Ishak, can you clearly answer the question, what is air pollution?
Yes, of course. Air pollution is the addition of harmful chemicals, toxins, particulate and other biological materials in the air, which leads to discomfort to living beings on the surface of Earth, damaging the environment.
So, Ms. Ishak, can you tell us about the effects on the environment?
Air pollution will cause acid rain, global warming and ozone depletion for the environment.
Yes, it's very obvious that the air pollution will affect the daily activities to get the things worse. Ms. Isha, can you tell us the causes of it?
One of the major causes in carbon dioxide, which is the highest discharge pollutant in nature as living beings exhale it. Another cause is carbon monoxide, is yet another harmful gas which is released because of the fuel burning appliances like automobiles, water heaters and others.
So, it is very important for all of us to know about the causes of air pollution. So, Mrs. Isha, can you suggest us some ways to prevent air pollution? Can you tell us some effective methods by which we can prevent air pollution?
Three ways to prevent air pollution, which includes family, society and transportation. For the family part, we can save electricity by using compact fluorescent lights and solar equipment. Besides, the housewife can convert a propane grill to natural gas to cook. We can use the air pollution control equipment system to check on the pollution caused. Use recycled product or gaining product to prevent the creation of waste, so there will be less need to burn rubbish to get rid of it. Other one is transportation apart. When possible, walk or bike to close by work locations, use of carpools or mass transit service vehicle on time, always insist on cleaning. Switch off your vehicles while waiting. And the last part is society. Our local authorities should run random check on the imposed hefty fines. The last but not least, non-governmental organizations can conduct public education such as plan a tree and prevention of smoke. I hope my speech has given you useful information on air pollution and some of the measures that we can do to help prevent it.
Thank you so much, Isha, for spending your quality time with us. God bless you.